it's Rose. Today we're going to take a look at SensorPush, which is a Bluetooth temperature sensor. At $49.99, it's a little bit pricier than the competition, but after researching and also after testing the simple link sensor tag by Texas Instruments, I feel confident in saying that this device is worth a little bit more money.
Setting up SensorPush takes seconds. You download the app, touch the sensor to your phone, and you're good to go. Within the app, you can use it as is, or you can calibrate temperature and humidity. From the same screen, you can set up alerts that will let you know if the measurements fall outside of your set range. A limitation of Bluetooth is that you can only get alerts when within range, but SensorPush is launching a Wi-Fi bridge soon that will expand the device's capabilities. In the meantime, the sensor offers internal storage and can hold data for up to 20 days. When you're back in range, it will push the data to the cloud where you can view it from your app for the hour, day, week, month, or year in Fahrenheit or Celsius. And you can even export data and send it to yourself via email. From the main screen, you can view quick trending data so you know if the measurements are holding steady, rising, or declining. But the big question is, how does SensorPush perform against promised features?
Of course, SensorPush's biggest promise is that it will send you a notification on your smartphone if the temperature range goes too high, too low, or if the humidity gets out of control, depending upon what you've set as appropriate. So right now, it's reading at 66.6 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm gonna stick it in the fridge, and I've set a limit of 64 degrees. So not sure how quickly it should take it to drop 2.5 degrees, but we'll see how fast it lets us know that there's a problem. And there we go. Oh, 1 minute, 28 seconds. I already know that SensorPush will automatically reconnect to your phone when it's back in range, which is something that sets it apart from Texas Instruments, which definitely does not automatically reconnect. But the question is, when you're back in range, how quickly will it let you know that there was a problem while you were away? So I've got the sensor in the fridge this time, it's nice and cool. I'm gonna turn my phone's Bluetooth back on and we will see if it lets me know that there's a problem. Right away, SensorPush determined below the limit of 60 degrees at 1:14 p.m. So instantly when my phone reconnected, it let me know that the sensor has an issue. Pretty good.
Finally, they promise a typical temperature reading accuracy of plus or minus 3% and humidity of plus or minus 4.5%. When measuring SensorPush against my other temperature and humidity sensors, this claim seems to hold true, for the most part, with humidity needing minor calibration.
Personally, I would prefer a Wi-Fi enabled device that will let me know if there's an issue regardless of if I'm home or if I'm away. But I understand that there are times when Bluetooth really is the only option. And if that's the case for you, I think that SensorPush is currently the best option on the market. If you want to compare SensorPush to four other Bluetooth temperature sensors, click on the link below and you can read my comparison as well as a little bit more information on my test results with the TI sensor. Otherwise, feel free to comment below with any questions that you have, and I just appreciate y'all spending time with me today, and I will see you later.